Here we see a 1x1 inch image. Because DPI, or dots per inch, can be a difficult subject, I will visualize it one more time. A dot is simply a square pixel. So if we would print just one single pixel, at the size of 1 inch, we would literally have a 1 DPI image. The next step up would be a 2 DPI image, which now consists of 4 colored squares. A 3 DPI image looks like this. And this is 4 DPI. Starting at 300 DPI, the image can be printed without seeing the pixels. In Scribus, I would like to get a warning when the image resolution, or DPI, drops below 300. At this moment Scribus gives a warning, but only for images below 144 DPI. But 144 DPI is too low. I also want to see the whole image when I import an image. So not just a part of it. To change this, I go to the preferences. Make sure no documents are open. Go to File, Preferences. Click on Item Tools. Then click on Images. I change free scaling to scale image to frame size. I will also set the preview quality of imported images to full resolution. This means you will see the actual image in Scribus. Normal or low image preview is there for older computers that struggle with showing the actual images. Now click on Preflight Verifier. Here, I set minimum resolution to 300 DPI. To avoid seeing an exclamation mark for high resolution images, I increase maximum resolution to 4000 DPI. I click on OK. When I create a new document and import an image, the image now fits inside the frame. And when an image drops below 300 DPI, I get a warning inside the frame. Now that image frames have been set by default to frame size, if you want to crop an image, choose free scaling. By dragging the sides inward, you can crop the image. If you double-click on the image, you can move the image independent of the frame. Press Escape to leave content mode, and you can adjust the frame again. Another way to move the image independent of the frame is to adjust the X position and the Y position in the image properties. In the next lecture, we will look at how to use text as an image frame, how to modify image frames, and how to create creative image frames.